Good morning. We start with breaking news unfolding in Canberra right now and straight to our federal politics reporter, Kerry Yaxley. Kerry, good morning. The government has just had a win.
Yeah, it has, Davina. Just in the last few minutes, the Senate has voted to repeal medevac legislation after the government secured Jacqui Lambie's crucial vote. Senator Lambie was in tears as she told the chamber that she can't tell us what she asked for from the government in order to secure her support to repeal the legislation. She said making it would compromise national security. And just as a reminder, Parliament passed the medevac legislation before the last election against the government's will. It allowed for two doctors to give the green light for the transfer of asylum seekers in offshore detention to the Australian mainland for medical treatment. The minister could overrule the transfer, but only on security grounds. And the government made no secret of the fact that it wanted this legislation gone. This morning, in a fiery Senate debate, the opposition accused the coalition of operating in secrecy. Senate leader Matthias Cormann said that there was no secret deal with Senator Lambie, which sounded a little different from what Senator Lambie herself had to say.
My hand is on my heart, and I can stand here and say that I would be putting at risk Australia's national security and national interest if I said anything else about this.
There is no secret deal. Let me repeat that again. There is no secret deal. There is no secret. The Australian people know extremely well the work that we have done to strengthen our border protection arrangements.
This ultimately is not just about the substance, it is about the role of this chamber. And it is about whether policy can be made in the shadows or whether it is subjected to some sunlight.
Approximately 180 asylum seekers had been transferred via medevac since the 2nd of March. Davina, all of them are still in Australia. Repealing this legislation is a much-needed win for the government in the Senate after One Nation surprised everyone last Thursday and voted against the government's union-busting bill.